we're talking about the intimacy, I'll make a little shift to another side of the intimacy which God showed me. You know how he is involved in us, Jesus. Go to Luke 10. How many of you want more? How many of you have set your focus on him? 10th chapter, okay? It's all about intimacy, the relationship, how Jesus is showing it. Let's see that. Jesus is rejoicing about the disciples coming back to Jesus. That's the incidence we are telling them about the power, that's the name of God, and that they could, drive demons and all that. And then you see a lawyer coming to Jesus, okay? A lawyer coming to Jesus. Look at the way the whole conversation took place. Relative to intimacy, verse 25 onwards. And a certain lawyer arose to try him, saying, "Teacher, what am I to do to inherit everlasting life?" Jesus said to him, "What is written in the law? How do you read it?" And he replied, "You must love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your strength, and with all your might." Okay? This is another key God showed me, the Holy Spirit showed me a few days ago, 27. Okay? How you get into that realm of the supernatural? Only through the step of intimacy. Okay, so intimacy is the door. He's telling with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your strength. See, look at that. So it is not haphazardly done. It's not here, some, there, some. It's 100% total focus. Jesus is telling the man, "You will love the Lord." Look at that in a new way. Intimacy means love. Intimacy is relationship. Intimacy is nearness. Intimacy is, quality time. Intimacy is focus. Yeah? Intimacy is waiting, seeking, trusting, loving. So here he's telling, you must love the Lord. Must love the Lord. Must love the Lord, your God. You must love the Lord. You must love the Lord. So nothing else will take your attention. That's the struggle. Nothing else will take your attention. You will love the Lord wholesome, 100%. See? So love the Lord your God with all your heart. With all your heart. So you will all the time, this is one thing that, it's a must, it's a real must. Like going before the Lord and showing your heart before him, saying, "Oh God, this whole heart is yours. His whole heart is for you. I value this heart's condition when I worship you, when I talk to you. This whole heart is yours. I don't care what. This whole heart is given to you." And then your soul, that means everything that is in the compartment of the soul, all the compartment of the soul. It's not one, it's not two, it's almost nine. All the compartment of the soul. So we keep bringing the compartments, the entrance of the soul before the Lord, and we will keep on saying, "See, if I am bothered with the door of imagination, I'm bothered with the door of imagination, of imagining, not God, imagining negative, imagining sickness, imagining." So, if that is my gate, low in quality, in operation. I bring the gate again to him, the door of grace again to him. This is no good. This is no good. Changes. Put your file there. So he comes and changes every part. So find out which entrance of yours, the soul entrance, is weak, it's not strong. Find which soul entrance not weak, not strong. And so you will just keep with all your soul, with all your soul. My emotions with him, my will with him, my purpose with him, my action with him, my intuition with him. See, like this, you will pick it and give it to him and totally there. So what happens is, your whole of your attention, your focus, and every rest of the stuff is with him. See, for example, you will say, Father, I entangle myself with you. Come on, everybody, repeat that. What you do is, sincerely, seriously, you imagine the act of entanglement with the Father. You say, Father, I engage you. Yeah. Say that. You will feel that. Father, engage you. So the sovereign God, the Father, needs that word to be said. So you tell him, Father, engage you right now. Father, engage you. Father, Jesus, I entangle you. Jesus, I entwine myself. So like this, you make a relationship on purpose. On purpose. It's all on purpose. You make it on purpose. Is this God so rude that he wants this from you? No. You make it a chance for your whole being to get involved with God, and he loves it. He loves it, and he will come and he will teach him, because everything else is given. That's why you don't want to even talk unnecessarily. You don't want to hurt him, his presence unwantedly. And so you're careful what's coming out of your mouth, what's running here. That's the main point. For me, this is the main point. So something running here. You know, fear and the shame and the anxiety or all this doubt, it's running here. It doesn't go away. And so you work on that. And he says, with all your mind and with all your strength, you make the appointment, your physical strength. And your emotional strength is saturated by physical strength. Imagine. And then your love, your neighbor as yourself. That means your relationship, you know, with everyone. Your relationship, you keep up your relationship. But even the old something, maybe in India, or something in the childhood, if we are hurt, you can't have a proper 100% embrace with this God. That's what I talk of. If you're hurt purposely, on purpose, something happened 20 years back will come to your memory to remind you of some hurt. My God, So if you throw that away, you will have the sweet embrace of God. So that's what I found out. So love is a matter. Did you love enough? No. You could get the point. So he's telling, love your neighbor as yourself. So I put it there, even though it's hard for me to follow. I will say, God, really? Okay, I will pray. You know, so also some years back, maybe in your family, maybe hard, maybe. But you say, okay, I will love. So this is how God comes and talks. So this chapter he showed me, and then he showed me this 28th verse. Jesus said to him, you have answered correctly. Do this, do this. Who said? Jesus. Do this. What that Jesus is expecting him to do? Do this. And you will live, enjoy active, blessed, endless life in the kingdom of God. You get the point here? Active, endless life in the kingdom of God. It is not after death. It is right now, right here. You got it? Right now, right here. So, to Nicodemus, Jesus said, from now on, you will see angels ascending and descending. That's the story. Today, how many confirmation of a great, tall, big angels? This is it. You shall see the angels ascending and descending. From now on, that means it's a cool path of a believer. You will see. So he's saying that is the life in the kingdom here on this earth. That is the life in the kingdom. It says endless life, say amen. Endless life in the kingdom. You are not an earthen somebody here, a human being, somebody. No. You are totally connected to the kingdom of God. Amen. That's why this easy relationship happening in you. Let us make it stronger. Amen. That's the intention now. For God to give us this teachings and reminding us again, saying, okay, you will have this strong relationship with me, and then you see what I can do for you now. Just the beginning that we are all focusing, look at this, what happened to me. So this will be the endless life. And this will be an active life. So you won't have to sit in the church to enjoy that, because it's going to be non-stop. Even when you are driving, even when you are in the mall, even when you are in the work, even wherever you are connected. You are connected. The kingdom of God is active. Hold those words. It's endless. So I don't want to damage it. How would you? Be really focused and get connected. It's a job. I tell you. You get so connected. Please, listen now. If you have not been before, get connected. You will go lie down, you start to sleep, and from nowhere you are awakened. You're just awakened. And you say, okay, I connect with you now. Sleep gone, all gone. You don't feel sad for it. You are connected. Because inside of you the connection is done, and you are easy to connect. You get the point? We pray and we wish that type of a supernatural intervention from God will take place in everyone's life. Amen. He will come in, you know, he will come and barge in your personal life and bring it to himself. And it will not be hard for you to connect or to talk. You see? So let's get into that realm of the supernatural zone. Don't you think so? You get into the realm of the supernatural zone of making the intimate relationship more strong. You got it? It's becoming what? More strong, because you are really intending to do it. How many of you really like it? And so then the next one I was shown is this, with verse 38, same chapter. Now, while they were on their way, it occurred that Jesus entered a certain village, and a woman named Martha received and welcomed him into her house. Martha received and welcomed him into her house. Imagine that. Martha was the one who was initiating the invitation to Jesus. He entered into a village and he came across a woman named Martha. Some woman named Martha. So she initiated, she received, welcomed him into her house. So that means whole of the house of Bethany belonged to her. It's called Lazarus' house, but the Bethany house was her house. So Martha's house, we never thought like that. She had a sister named Mary who seated herself at the Lord's feet and was listening to his teaching. That is building up intimate relationship. So building up intimate relationship, Martha invited her into her house, Mary built up the relationship. You see, Martha invited Jesus, but Mary built the relationship. So the intimacy, the relationship needs total wholesome attention from the receiver to the giver, right? So the receiver is sitting at the feet of Jesus. The giver is connected to the receiver. Imagine you, we are talking, exaggerating the known story because we want to be there in Mary's place. Is that true? Yes. We want to be there in Mary's place, not just leaving here, you know. So you can imagine Mary sitting at the feet of Jesus, completely getting his focus and his 100% eye contact. Catch hold of that. 100% eye contact. Like the Shulamite having the eye contact with the king. So the king turns to tell you, listen, please take your eyes from me, because with one of your eyes, with one of your eyes, you have, you know, won my heart. You see the intimacy with one of your eyes. That means your eyes are so powerful, gazing upon me. Intimacy, gazing upon me, waiting and being lost in the sovereignty of God. So Mary did that. And then what Jesus showing? Martha overly occupied. Put that over there as if you never heard it before. Overly occupied. See, we have many things to be occupied. Mother has so many things to be occupied. Like look after the children, bathe them, feed them, teach them, look after them, mind clothes. My father has so many, several things. Go to the market, you know, drive the car, and buy the fish, and buy the vegetables. See, all these are errands. Top of that, if you have any other activities, you are completely occupied. Listen, if we are occupied, you know, only one thing I learned was when I used to be bombarded with the rest of the stuff that I can't focus in my, my job, my life, this is my life, when I cannot, one thing I will always tell to myself, Latha, shift. This is not a workplace to live. It's draining you and it's killing you. Shift. Don't stay there. Shift. Don't pay attention. Shift. Don't let it occupy you. Shift. This is what I have learned till today. Anything that even my physical body speaks of, what I will say, shift. Otherwise, the survival connection, the feed with the Father, with the Creator, will be cut off. So he's telling, overly occupied and too busy. Keep that word, too busy. Intimacy with Jesus is killed by being busy. Cannot even busy in the ministry. Intimacy is different, ministry is different. Martha was doing the ministry, Mary was doing the intimacy. Martha was doing her job. It's that was ministry, example. And then, you know, intimacy. Intimacy different from the ministry. Yeah? So without intimacy, you do the ministry, it is powerless. Ask me, 30 plus years. It's powerless. But you have intimacy, spend 4 hours at home and come to church on Friday, whoa, you fly high. You got the point? So that is the difference. Always we teach that. Intimacy is more important than ministry. So if you want to do anything at all, in the kingdom. Intimacy is the matter. That you spend 4 hours with the Lord and come to church, that happily you can walk on water. You got the point? And so, so distracted. What is that? Distracted. Check the point which is distracted. Check the point which is distracted. The killer of intimacy is distracted. Many things happen. Office, work, children, school, many things. What is taking your attention? Okay. Always there will be something to distract you from doing the will and purpose of God, which is written in your scroll. The damage comes to distract you totally from the job God has written in your scroll. Always there is a conflict. So be very careful, distracted. With what is serving? That's what the ministry, maybe example. And she came up to him and said, Lord, is it nothing to you that my sister has left me to serve alone? Tell her then to come help me and to lend a hand. So the Lord replied to her, this is my attention here. The Lord replied to her by saying, Martha, Martha, you are anxious. See, twice it's mentioned. Not once. Twice her name is mentioned. Twice, if anything is mentioned in the Bible, that means it is mentioned purposely to get attention. Yeah? Verily, verily, I say unto you, to get attention. Verily, verily, I say unto you, to get attention. That means it's very important. So Martha, Martha, that means not one time. Jesus is telling Martha, Martha. So into us there is a Martha living, yeah, and a Mary living. Right? So we have every right to say, Martha, Martha, keep quiet. Yeah, into us a Mary living and a Martha living. And so we all of a sudden we shift to the Martha life. And it's nice and easy, do you know that? It's fun, full of fun. But after a few hours, you will say, my goodness, I am a vacuum now. I don't feel God now, I do nothing now, you see? So Martha is inside, Mary is inside. Altar call, give altar call. I am in the journey of intimate relationship with my God. Mary, arise. When you command the Mary to arise in you, it's easy when you are waking up at 2 o'clock, 2:30 o'clock, at 3 o'clock, at 3:30 o'clock, whatever clock, you are, okay. Relationship. This let it become more in our lives in Jesus' name. I want it. You are anxious and troubled about many things. So we are talking about that. The Martha stuff is what? Anxious and troubled about many things. So when we are troubled about many things, we are not having intimate relationship with God. Cannot have relationship with God. Yeah. We all know that. Troubled about many things. So the day is not going to be ended without this coming to us. We will be in the office, in the traffic, in the everywhere, the trouble, the distracted. There is need of only one. But a few things. The few things is written in italics. That means it's added in the smile. That means it's added. So there is a need of only one thing. There's need of only one thing. There's need of only one thing. Mary has chosen the good portion. Intimate relationship is a good portion. That which is to her advantage. Intimacy is to your advantage, which shall not be taken away from her. Amen. Which shall not be taken away from you. Which shall not be. What shall not be taken away from you? The relationship that you've got. The intimacy that you've started. Because you get a beautiful feeling within you when you are touched by the Lord and you know, impacted by the presence of the angels. Is that wonderful? So this is one part of the story that I have. Those who are in this journey, go deeper. Not only here, let the angels be seen in your house. Let the angels come with you in the car. Let the angels talking, the voices of heaven be heard. Holy Father, we thank you for what you did. Oh, today in this place, thank you for coming. Thank you for connecting with you. The kingdom of God is nearer than ever before right now, because we have been focusing into coming into you. So show us the mystical relationship that we are aiming at, the mystical relationship that your people, your saints have been walking in, the mystical connection, the supernatural work. Take us through the intimate journey with you in this season, so that our inner man will be very connected and strong with the kingdom of God. And we will say, kingdom of God is at hand. And going and coming, like going up and down, to and fro, will be easy for us. So we honor you, God, for all the revelation that you are bringing. We honor you for coming and worshiping with us. We honor you for touching us. We value everything that you've done. We don't take it for granted. We don't dishonor you by, Lord, distracting ourselves somewhere else. We are here focused in you. And so come and interfere in our lives. Wake us up in the middle of the night, very early of the day. God, wake us up any time and speak to us. And let the angels walk within our home and in our room. God, let us be focused on you as we always want. Cover all what had happened today in every person's life, and also the healing touch that every person received. In Jesus Christ's mighty name.